This week on HomeKit News, the WiiM Mini Audio Streamer with AirPlay 2. Today's gadget is the rather small but powerful WiiM Mini, designed to turn any audio gear smart. The way it achieves this is with the aid of AirPlay 2. It works with Spotify as well as being compatible with Amazon A. However, before we go any further, how it works may be of use to some of you. So if you have iTunes or Apple Music on, say, your computer, iPhone or iPad, you can AirPlay the audio to the WiiM, which once connected to things like an amplifier, soundbar or even powered speakers, allows the music to be played through those devices. One thing to note is that it's not compatible with Google, but in addition to AirPlay functionality, it can work directly with a whole host of other streaming platforms, including Napster, Amazon Music, and Tidal, for example. So, what's in the box? First is a manual in English, French, Spanish, and German, along with the WiiM Mini itself, which looks a bit like those old Amazon Echo buttons. Here are some specs for the device, so pause the video if you need to. But highlights include 5 GHz Wi-Fi, touch controls, an audio import, and a digital output for high-res audio. As you can imagine, it's a bit of a fingerprint magnet, but you do get these useful controls, which you'll look at closer in a bit. Aside from the WiiM itself, the company generously provide 3 different audio cables. Now, the first of these is a 3.5mm stereo jack plug to stereo phono connectors. There's a USB-C to USB-A power cable, although there's no provided USB power supply. Also provided is an optical audio cable for digital output, and finally a 3.5mm stereo jack-to-jack cable. So let's have a closer look at the device now, and at the back there are 2 3.5mm jack sockets, an audio in and an audio out, both of which are analog. You can plug devices into the audio in socket, but that won't send the signal to other AirPlay devices, however. Next to these is the power port, which I'm happy to report uses USB-C. Next to that is the digital out, which uses the optical digital audio cable we saw previously. There's also a small mic to monitor audio for syncing purposes. On top of the device are 3 simple audio controls with a play pause button in the middle, flanked by volume controls. There's also a small LED which can be turned off. It's quite impressive that all of this functionality is squeezed into a small puck sized at just 2.72 inches in diameter and just 1 inch deep. So that's pretty small. I've got a basic setup here to demonstrate AirPlay 2 in action, starting off with a track playing on my iPhone. If I select the WiiM from the list, the audio then passes through to the soundbar that's connected to the WiiM. As you can see, I'm able to control playback via the buttons at the top, which allows me to both play and pause the audio streaming to the WiiM. I can also adjust the audio levels with the volume controls, but the one thing to note is that the volume controls only work with the WiiM, not other AirPlay devices that may be part of the AirPlay group. As this device is AirPlay 2 compatible, I can add other AirPlay devices to the mix, like my HomePod Mini, for multi-room audio. So being that it's an AirPlay 2 device, I can add this to the Home app, even though it doesn't come with a HomeKit code. You can see the tile for the WiiM here. Tapping on the tile doesn't control playback like you would get with a HomePod Mini, however. Instead, it opens up playback controls and the settings panel. As it's in the Home app, this means it can also be used in scenes and automations, which makes it really handy. Although you might find that automations for AirPlay is a little limited right now. If I scroll down a bit to my Belkin Soundform Connect, you can see that it can also be used in scenes and automations, and you also get a less generic icon than with the WiiM, if that matters. Additionally, the Belkin allows you to play and pause from the tile, seeing as it's a full HomeKit device that comes with a QR code. Here's Apple Music on my iPhone showing my AirPlay devices, which includes both the WiiM Mini and the Arylic A50 Plus, I reviewed not so long ago, although it's only AirPlay 1. If I now hop over to the WiiM app, you can see both the WiiM Mini and the A50 Plus listed. In fact, if you want, you can actually sync these two devices together outside of AirPlay, if necessary, along with other WiiM or Arylic devices. In the Browse section, you have access to a few different options as well as access to the streaming services previously mentioned. In this section, you can also set the audio output mode, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth or line-in. Wi-Fi is the setting you need for AirPlay, of course. Bluetooth allows you to connect directly from your phone or iPad if that's what you prefer. Other settings include the Wi-Fi status, alarm clock options, and even a large set of EQ presets, which is handy for things like my Xiaomi soundbar, which doesn't even have any EQ options at all. So what are my thoughts on the WiiM Mini? Well, the physical controls on the device, whilst basic, are really useful for quick hands-on control. I'm also really pleased they offer a 5 GHz Wi-Fi connection, which still isn't utilised nearly enough. For those that may not use Apple Music or don't even have an iPhone or iPad, the Bluetooth and line-in connections are a real bonus. After having tried the Arylic A50, it's great to have an AirPlay device that can be used within the Home app, so that's another plus. And the fact that they give you all the cables you really need pushes this way past Belkin's offering, which gives you none of these, but for the same price. The only possible con, although I'm not sure if it's a HomeKit or AirPlay limitation, is that the volume controls on the device only work for audio on the WiiM, not other AirPlay devices playing at the same time. Other than that, this is a really decent little device to get AirPlay to some of your older but still loved audio equipment, and for the price you do get a lot, so I really have no real complaints. That's our overview of the WiiM Mini, but if you have any questions or comments, you know what to do. Please like, subscribe and share if you haven't done so already, and until the next time, stay safe and say the word rotator backwards.